Six Lessons on Raja Yoga by Swami Vivekananda, published by Advaita Ashrama, a publication center of Ramakrishna Math, Belur Math. Six Lessons on Raja Yoga. Raja Yoga is as much a science as any in the world. It is an analysis of the mind, gathering the facts of the super sensuous world, and so building up the spiritual world. All the great spiritual teachers the world has known said, "I see and I know." Jesus, Paul, and Peter all claimed actual perception of the spiritual truths they taught. This perception is obtained by yoga. Neither memory nor consciousness can be the limitation of existence. There is a superconscious state. Both it and the unconscious state are sensationless, but with a vast difference between them, the difference between ignorance and knowledge. Present yoga is an appeal to reason as a science. Concentration of the mind is the source of all knowledge. Yoga teaches us to make matter our slave, as it ought to be. Yoga means yoke, to join, that is, to join the soul of man with the supreme soul of God. Mind acts in and under consciousness. What we call consciousness is only one link in the infinite chain that is our nature. This eye of ours covers just a little consciousness and a vast amount of unconsciousness, while over it, and mostly unknown to it, is the superconscious plane. Through faithful practice, layer after layer of mind opens before us, and each reveals new facts to us. We see, as it were, new worlds created before us. New powers are put into our hands, but we must not stop by the way or allow ourselves to be dazzled by these beads of glass when the mine of diamonds lie before us. God alone is our goal. Failing to reach God, we die. Three things are necessary to the student who wishes to succeed. First, giving up all ideas of enjoyment in this world and the next. Care only for God and truth. We are here to know truth, not for enjoyment. Leave that to brutes who enjoy as we never can. Man is a thinking being and must struggle on until he conquers death, until he sees the light. He must not spend himself in vain talking that bears no fruit. Worship of society and popular opinion is idolatry. The soul has no sex, no country, no place, no time. Second, intense desire to know truth and God. Be eager for them, long for them, as a drowning man longs for breath. Want only God, take nothing else. Let not seeming cheat you any longer. Turn from all and seek only God. Third, the six trainings. First, restraining the mind from going outward. Second, restraining the senses. Third, turning the mind inward. Fourth, suffering everything without murmuring. Fifth, fastening the mind to one idea. Take the subject before you and think it out. Never leave it. Do not count time. Sixth, think constantly of your real nature. Get rid of superstition. Do not hypnotize yourself into a belief in your own inferiority. Day and night, tell yourself what you really are until you realize, actually realize, your oneness with God. Without these disciplines, no results can be gained. We can be conscious of the Absolute, but we can never express it. The moment we try to express it, we limit it, and it ceases to be Absolute. We have to go beyond sense limit and transcend even reason, and we have the power to do this. After practicing the first lesson in breathing for a week, the pupil reports to the teacher. First lesson. This is a lesson seeking to bring out the individuality. Each individuality must be cultivated. All will meet at the center. Imagination is the door to inspiration.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.